Yes, dear children, as I told you previous class, I will give two tables. Children, among them, this is the table one. This is the table one. Children, when we have to know completely without any misunderstanding, we have to learn all the rules and this type of tables. When we apply at the time of changing the active voice into passive or passive into active, at that time we should apply all these rules and the tables also. I will give you another one. This is table one. Table two is there. Okay, children, see, with the help of those tables, assertive rules plus interrogative sentence rules plus imperative sentence rules plus exclamatory sentence rules also applied. See, if a sentence is an assertive, all these rules we have to. If an interrogative sentence, the same rules will apply. Yes, the same rules also, along with other additional rules also. In imperative, the same. How let will begin in imperative sentences, like that. I will give you the examples also, don't worry. And exclamatory sentence also, I will give you the examples also for that, how we can change the imperative sentences, interrogative sentences like this. I already told you, I gave the examples of assertive sentences. Okay, if you know any one sentence really that was not useful, children, you please come to have an complete idea, then only you will be perfect. Okay, children, see there, children, while we are going to change the active into passive, at that time this table will be more helpful than the rules also. Okay, see there, table one, active voice. This part is active voice, this is passive voice. How active voice verbs and modals will change in passive voice. Okay, see there, English grammar is just like a mathematics, children. How the mathematic rules we are going to learn at the time of solve the equation, solve the problem, in the same way here also we have to apply all those tables, we have to learn all these tables. See there, advice. V1, as I told you already, V1, V2, V3, V1, ing. V1 is a simple present, V2 is simple past, and V3 is past participle, and V1 ing is present participle. In the same way, V1 S plus ES, SRES, SRES, SRES means singular or plural, singular or plural, present tense. For example, write, writes. Singular or plural, like this, singular or plural, it will come is, am, are, plus V3, plus V3. See there, in passive constructions, the main verb should be in V3, should be in V3. That is why V3 means past participle, past participle. Don't get confused here. See there, in V2 means, as you know, past tense. See there, was, were, plus V3. Was, were, plus V3. I will give you an example, then only you can understand. See there, if in a sentence has will come, had will come, or have will come along with its proper verb, at that time has, had, if has come, has been, plus V3. If it is had come, had been plus V3. If it is have come, have been plus V3. If it in active voice has is there, in passive voice has been. In active voice had is there, in passive voice had been. In active voice have is there, in passive voice have been plus V3. Have been plus V3. This is not for the to learn, not to learn. Please don't forget here. See there. Next, is, am, are, was, were plus V1 ing. Is, am, are, was, were plus V1 ing. If it comes, V1 ing means present participle. Present participle, continuous tense. He is writing, he is playing, she is dancing, like this. Is, am, are, was, were plus continuous tense. No. So when continuous tense will come, at that time being should be used. Being plus V3. Being plus V3. Note down, children. This is very important here. And what else? Will, shall, can, plus V1, etc. Will write, shall write, I can do it, like this, it will come in models. Will, shall, can, etc. like this. If will come, will be plus V3. If can come, can be plus V3. Like this, children, this table provides ample information for your learning. Please note down all this one, and please go through this table, and I already gave you in previous class the rules also. What is the rules? Active voice, object is changed into passive voice, subject. Active voice, subject is changed into passive voice, object. The verb V1 or V2 should be changed into V3. The fourth one, fourth rule is suitable changes are made in personal pronoun. Next one, fifth one, tenses should not be changed. Plus this table, and plus I will give you next another one table also. I will give you one or two example to explain how this table will apply. Okay, see there, children. For example, as I told you, the cat kills the mice. Okay, children, the cat kills the mice. Here, the cat is subject, kills is verb. The cat is subject, kills is verb, the mice is object. See, this is active voice. AV, change into PV. The mice, see there. The mice are, because helping verb is essential, mice is plural, and this is present tense, plural, helping verb are, as I told you early, are, and killed, kills, this is V1, it should be changed into V2, killed by who? Killed by the cat. In the same way, I will change this one, and then only you can understand it clearly. See there, the cat killed the mice. See there, which is the subject? This one. Which is the verb? This one. Which is the object? This one. The mice, take that one. The mice here. See there, the cat, the mice are. Here the mice were, because mice is plural, verb is past tense plural helping verb were. The mice were. Then this is V2, previous one V1, now this is V2, V1 or it may be V2, it should be changed into V3, killed by whom? By the cat. By the cat, the subject of a active voice is changed into object of a passive voice. And you should, you can apply like this. See there, V2, V2, were plus V3, killed by, see there, were plus V3, killed by the, by an agent, the cat. Okay, I will give you another one example here. Please children, the cat has killed the mice. Killed the mice. You see children here, this is the subject, this is the main verb, and this is object, this is model, helping verb. You can say helping verb or model. Okay, change the mice, because active voice subject object is changed into passive voice subject. The mice here has, this is present tense singular, because the cat is singular, here has is singular, here mice is plural, so you should use have. Have, okay, should use have. See there, have is there, plus in passive sentences been, have been, the mice have been killed. Been plus V3, killed by whom? Killed by the cat. Like this children, see there, the mice have been killed by the cat. The mice have been killed by the cat. Here has is used singular, has it shows singular, so the cat is also singular here, that is why here has is used. But the mice is plural here, so you should change a plural helping verb, singular helping, from singular helping verb to plural helping verb. Have plus been plus V3, have plus been plus V3, killed by the cat. Like this, you should apply this table to your changes, then you will be perfect, and your translation is also perfect one. Okay children, can I give the second table, table number 2, this is table number 1, table number 2, okay, thank you. I will give you the second table, please note this one, thank you children.